Apokalipsa u gudičkom zvuku, zanimljivom. u kompoziciji se ogleda vizualna forma luka I kruga, kao što vidite. Ovo je malo rašireno da bi stalo na ekranu, ali zapravo jeste jedan krug, ta rozeta. I muzički parametri su zasnovani na proporcijama 6, 8, 9 I 12, koje ona meni pokazala jednom ovom grafikom, ali ona je prilično, prilično sitna, pa onda ko želi to da prouči, možemo da mu prosledimo partituru, pa vidi o čemu se radi. Vratit ću na rozetu, pošto ona nije tu. Onda je nekako lepo I dobro ide u Justininu muziku. Sve vreme trajanja kompozicije koristi se maksimalna podela kamernog ludačkog orkestra, izlažu se različite slojeve kulture koji se postepeno ujedinjuju ili sukobljavaju. Svaki od ovih slojeva indukuje tembralne promene, dok svaki instrument pravi suptilni dodatak klasteru tonova, učestvujući u kreiranju globalnih zvučnih blokova. Znači, šart je tajnovit, arhaičan, na nekom čudnom mestu između konsonance I disonance. Ovde imamo neka pitanja koje smo spremili za Justinu, pa ako se slažete, ja mogu da je pozovem sad na Skype da vidimo šta će ona reći. Za slučaj da ne radi veza, mi smo spremili jedan video koji je ona bila ljubazna da nam pošalje. Ali ja se nadam da ćemo moći da pričamo. Hello, Justina, how are you?
Hello, I'm fine, how are you?
Fine, thanks. We have a great audience and the orchestra is here. Maybe I can show you some.
It would be lovely. Hello! It's nice meeting you.
Okay. Those are mostly students of composition, musicology, mostly performers from the string orchestra, and our friends also from the faculty.
You're playing my music.
Yes, how do you like Justina's music?
Interesting.
Anyone? I think they are playing very well, you will hear them. We can also let you on Skype, but just on my microphone, and then you will get the final recording after the concert. But you can stay on Skype if you want to.
Yeah, why not to try that?
Okay. So, what are you doing in Paris now? How does your day look like?
Well, I have many projects, but part of them are abroad, like I have one project in Armenia, another one in Egypt. My music will be played next month in Vienna, and I'm very happy that my music is brought to Serbia.
We also are, yes, of course, we know some of Lithuanian composers, but we're not so familiar with them. Maybe 5 years ago we are making better contacts with Lithuania, and I'm sure that it will be better in time. So, can I ask you some other questions that I collected from our students?
Yes, of course.
Of course. Which styles mostly attract your attention through the history of music and why?
Yeah, I'm very fascinated about medieval music and my biggest interest is the end of the medieval world, so the end of 14th century, Ars Superior music, which is not very well known because normally in books we found about Ars Nova music, but because Ars Superior was a style which took just like 30 years, and it's music which was written by very sophisticated composers. Mm-hmm. For other connoisseurs, so it wasn't a very accessible music at the time. And composers were creating an avant-garde of the time, and so that's why the music is so complicated, rhythmically, harmonically, and even text speaks about hidden meaning, and it's even today it's not easy to understand what we meant. by text or music? Is it irony or is it serious?
It sounds like some mystical text.
yes, sometimes, for example, we sing about I'm a smoky smoker. Even we know that at the time tobacco wasn't known in Europe, so there are some legends. So what do we mean about smoking at the time? Is it a thinking activity or something else?
Yes, something foggy.
Yes, and another example of avant-garde music in music history, which I appreciate very much, is Carlos Gesualdo music, especially his Tenebre Responsoriums. And his such a dissonant music wasn't appreciated at the time neither, but it is today. I think Gesualdo is very popular today. And when I skip classical music, because it interests me a little bit less, and I love the music of the 60s, but there are many compositions I do appreciate, and there are some giant composers which I love, like Gérard Griset, and of course in France he's very popular, and there are composers who are continuing his line of spectral music, Jean-Luc Hervé or Franck Bedrosian. And another giant composer which I appreciate and who is still a living composer and a star already is Salvatore Chirino. And he's one of the rare composers who has created a unique style in writing for voice.
Yes, for me somehow when you say Salvatore Chirino, I think about Umberto Eco, gigantic figures in two arts.
Italian line of great composers.
Yeah.
And speaking about Lithuanian composers, I think we are really proud about Rytis Mažiulis, who is a lecturer in the academy and who's writing quite a radical music of post-minimalism. So it's quite dissonant and difficult to perform, but we are very proud of him, and it gives a mysterious glimpse of Lithuania.
So you are also a vocal performer. You also improvise in medieval and contemporary music. How does it go together?
It's just that I had an opportunity to learn a little bit about different styles, how to improvise in medieval, medieval forms. And contemporary improvisation, it's an activity which musicians who are interested in playing contemporary music, they normally do both improvisation and contemporary performances. So for a composer, it's a great opportunity to meet other musicians.
Yes. Because normally we are your playing.
Yes. Yeah. And of course, to go outside of this box of a composer who stays at home and writes all alone. I mean, being on a stage and improvise, it's a creative process which is very spontaneous.
Very nice. You are a very brave composer.
Thank you.
What do you think about Xenakis' words, "I'm making music while geometrizing"? Maybe do you use similar techniques? You have here a proportion from 6 to 8 to 9 and 12. That's something that generates all the materials.
Yeah, for me, a term of a proportion is something same. I mean that it governs all my creation. And what I have common with Xenakis is that that I do start to thinking music from abstract ideas. So it can be a series of numbers or a painting or just a geometrical shape. So I start drawing things and then I translate it to music. And I think that Xenakis' approach was quite the same, except that he was more experience in the field of architecture, and it isn't my field.
Okay. Everyone has his field. So, can I ask you, What's your favorite composition for strings and why?
My favorite composition for strings is Alberto Posada's string quartet. Mm-hmm. It's a cycle, the name is Liturgia Fractal. And I think what's interesting about writing music for strings that it's a very homogenic ensemble. And as Posadas is so known about thanks to his fractal compositions, I think it sounds really beautiful because his compositions are very well generated, very homogenic. And for this line up of the same timbre, it sounds really great.
Okay. Is there any particular score which influenced Chartres?
No, as Chartres was thought from abstract ideas, I hadn't searched for scores to learn something. I was looking at the Chartres Cathedral to search for ideas, and when I have found that this South Rose window is showing 24 old men holding string instruments mm-hmm. of 13th century, I was just too inspired to ignore that. And so that's why I started to search for ways how to embody an arc of a circle in music. And what is the meaning of apocalypse in medieval thinking, and what it is for me a sounding of an apocalypse. And that's why I employed this proportion, 6:8, 9:12, to create something monumental and to appeal this medieval thinking of music as an art of a sounding number.
This piece should sound apocalyptical or not?
Yeah, I'm giving a liberty for an audience maybe not to know that it's about an apocalypse. So if I call a piece Chartres, it might give an allusion to Chartres Cathedral. But for those who are just hearing music, they can be stimulated in their own way, and it means that their own imagination can create maybe some pictures or feelings which are totally disconnected.
Yes, of course. Can I ask you some more questions about your composing process? How does it look like? Do you play your music ideas on piano, or you go directly on the paper, on the musical software?
Especially right now, my music is full of microtones. Playing it on piano would be quite sad. And as I start composing music, starting from abstract ideas, it's quite a visual approach. So I like draw things, and so I start writing on a paper, and sometimes it is even a millimetrical paper. So then I hang this drawing in my room, and I try to connect to it and find a way how to translate it to music. And of course, some material is impossible to translate to music. Mm-hmm. So even though if the idea appeared to be genuine in the beginning, most of the time I just trash it.
Yes. So I think you're a very visually oriented composer. So you have many visual impressions, and you work with some kind of plan, visual plan of your music.
Yeah, it's because when I was a child, I dreamed to become a visual artist. Mm-hmm. And I started visual arts before I started music. But when my teacher said that I had a talent in music and I was playing piano already, thanks to my mom, so I started to attend music school just for education. So I was a very busy child. I was doing both schools, art school and music school, and my parents thought that I would be a visual artist because I was claiming that for like 15 years. And when I found a way how to be creative in music, I dropped out visual arts and started composing.
Great. So can you ask something more about your life as a composer? Are you a freelancer? Do you can you manage to live from your work, or you have some other interests or some other engagements?
I have some scholarships here in France, and I am a part of Lithuanian Composers Union. I'm a part of SESEM, Authorship Union, which helps to collect the money for composers. And I also teach piano, voice, and solfège. I hope in the future I would be able to live just from my work, but I know that it's a dream. Even big composers today, we all have a teaching job, but of course the best is to teach a composition.
Yes. Well, if someone else in the audience has another question, I could just take it and tell it to you. To Justina, do you have something else you want to ask them? I mostly had all the questions from professors and students, and I think we have it all now. So if you like, you could listen a bit of a concert.
Of course.
They will now play your music, but we will have also a DVD and audio recording of this event.
Thank you very much.
Yes, and we will send it to you.
And thank you for sending me a picture of musicians. I was really surprised that you are such a young orchestra. And
yes, in this project we work with the student performance. And they have to learn, maybe for the first time, something like this. They are playing the time. I think they are great.
That's wonderful. Yeah, I'm looking forward to hearing their performance.
Thank you very much. We love to have you here sometimes, and we will invite you on some occasion, I hope, and play your music again.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much for your interest.
Thank you, and see you again. Bye. Okay. So maybe you still will stay here. And I will just get back to the pictures of her composition. It will come again. I thought it was Emiterati. Nadam se da ste mogli nešto dobiti do razgovora I da vam je bilo zanimljivo. Sada bih prepustila dirigentsku panicu našem Ivan Marković, kolegi I Josipu.
Thank you. Thank you. zajedno sa kolegama koji su učestvovali u opisu, vidite kako imamo kvalitetne izvođače, pišite za njih, nadam se da će oni želiti da sviraju našu muziku i dalje. I ja ću ponoviti ovaj susret sa nekom muzikom ili nekom vašom koju vi budete želiti da svirate ili nekom našom koju mi napišemo. Nadam se da se vidimo u ovom sastavu i da će i fakultet imati i ludački orkestar osnovu za podnesku, jer je to zaista divan medij. Hvala vam puno svima što ste bili večeras. Ovo je bilo sve.